When embroidery needles pierce fabric, they pull the material inwards. This can lead to puckering, bunching, or visible gaps in the design. To get clean, professional results, each object needs proper stitch spacing, enough pull compensation, and a good underlay, matched to the fabric and stitch type. Embroidery Studio includes smart tools that help place stitches evenly and eliminate design gaps. In this video, we'll explore how to use them. Embroidery Studio offers optimized settings for different fabrics. The current fabric appears in the status bar. Choosing the right fabric type is essential for high-quality results. Fabric settings are part of your design template and are fine-tuned for different materials. You typically select a fabric when starting a design, but you can change it at any time. Your fabric choice affects underlay, pull compensation, and type of cover stitching used. If your design doesn't already have a fabric set, the software will ask if the new fabric should apply to new objects only or to existing objects as well. The quality and appearance of your embroidery depend heavily on underlay. Think of it as the foundation for your cover stitching. Without it, embroidery tends to lie flat and the fabric may show through the design. New digitizers often try to fix this by increasing stitch density, but a better approach is to apply automatic underlay. While it adds to the stitch count, underlay helps stabilize the fabric and reduces puckering, especially on larger designs. It also adds loft, lifting the cover stitching so it doesn't sink into soft fabrics. And on textured or napped materials like towels or fleece, underlay can help flatten the surface before stitching begins. Embroidery Studio includes a feature called Auto Underlay. It's a simple toggle that applies underlay automatically to new or selected objects, based on their shape and cover stitch type. You may choose to turn off underlay altogether for special effects, like gradient fill. Different underlays suit different shapes and different fabrics. Larger objects may combine two layers. Stretchy fabrics like knits or pique need more underlay than firm materials like denim or leather. Remember, you can override the default underlay settings from your chosen fabric. But if you change fabrics later, those overrides will be lost. Free shapes usually stitch out in separate segments, connected by travel runs. By default, underlay is applied to each segment before the cover stitching. But in some cases, it's better to apply underlay across the entire shape, not just one segment at a time. This method, called by shape underlay, is used automatically for lettering. You can also apply it to complex turning objects and branched shapes. This helps reduce travel runs, stitch count, and thread buildup in tight areas. Keep in mind, on larger objects, using shape-based underlay may affect stitch alignment, so always check your registration if precision is important. With Embroidery Studio, auto underlay is usually applied on an object-by-object basis. Default settings are determined by object size and shape and the current auto fabric. Sometimes, however, you may want to apply a global underlay to a group of objects or an entire design, particularly if you're having registration issues. Select the objects you want to apply global underlay to. Turn off auto underlay. Using the Outlines and Offsets tool, create a turning fill object offset by, say, -2 mm. Choose the color you want to use for the global underlay. An underlay is generated for these objects only and placed after them in the stitching sequence. Switch to lay down stitch type and reposition the underlay in the stitching sequence. Double-click to access object properties and adjust as necessary. Apply closest join and run the stitch player to study the stitch out. Sometimes you need to control stitch direction to minimize trims, pull-push effect, improve stitching efficiency, or reinforce outlines. Backtrack and repeat allow you to reinforce outlines while specifying stitching direction. Backtrack is typically used with open shapes and stitches in reverse direction to the original. It makes outlines thicker without creating unwanted connecting stitches. Repeat is typically used with closed shapes and duplicates the original stitch direction. If you use it with open shapes, a connecting stitch is inserted from the end to the start of the object. This will require trimming. Stitching direction can affect embroidery quality because of the pull-push effect. The reverse curves command allows you to reverse stitching direction without duplication. It can be applied to open as well as closed outline objects. Embroidery stitches naturally pull fabric inward where the needle enters. This can lead to puckering and visible gaps in your design. You can reduce this effect by applying underlay stitching and by using the right backing and topping during the stitch out. Another tool is automatic pull compensation. This helps by slightly overstitching filled shapes, especially along the edges where the fabric tends to pull in. The best settings depend on several factors, like the type of fabric, whether it's stretchy or has pile, how tightly the fabric is hooped, and the width of your stitched objects. Embroidery Studio's Auto Fabric feature adjusts pull compensation automatically based on the selected fabric. You can still override these settings if needed. You can also use the column width setting to make column shapes wider or narrower in the stitching direction. This is useful when you want to create bold lettering or fine-tune your design's appearance. For more information about embroidery reinforcement techniques, refer to the latest Embroidery Studio online help or reference manual. See links below. Thanks for watching.